Good evening. The state television company of Western Armenia represents the most important events of the week. Today's broadcast. The newly elected president of the Republic of Western Armenia, Armenak Abrahamian. The newly elected prime minister of the Republic of Western Armenia, Garnik Sarkisian. The newly elected president of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia, Ahvan Tonakanyan. The first and the second sessions of the second convocation of the National Assembly of Western Armenia were completed. In some parts of Western Armenia, the threat of earthquake has dropped. Ertat the architect, the unique art of embroidery in Maraş, Antep, and Urfa. Armenak Vresh Abrahamian, 59 years old, professor, founder, and the master of Armenian martial arts, Hayatjanpa. His roots are from Garin and Sebastia. From 1991 to 1997, volunteer of Artsakh People's and Human Rights Protection and co-founder of Artsakh Armed Forces. In 2004, founder and the president of the National Council of Western Armenia. In 2005, founder and the president of the Armenian Assembly of Western Armenia. Since 2005, he is a citizen of Western Armenia. In 2006, head of the Western Armenia delegation to the United Nations. In 2011, founder and member of the government of Western Armenia. In 2013, founder and member of the Western Armenia parliament. In the same year, he was elected as a deputy of the National Assembly of Western Armenia for a 5-year term. In 2014, he was elected as the president of the Republic of Western Armenia for a 5-year term by the deputies of the National Assembly of Western Armenia. On June 24 of 2016, as the president of the Republic of Western Armenia, he has ratified the Treaty of Sevres. On February 12 of 2017, as the president of the Republic of Western Armenia, he has ratified the Military Doctrine of the Western Armenia. On October 29 of 2017, with the elections of the National Assembly of Western Armenia, his candidacy in the elections of 2018 was officially confirmed. He is a researcher, historian, writer, analyst, psychologist, and the founder of the state television company of Western Armenia. In 2019, he was elected for a 5-year term by the second mandate as the President of the Republic of Western Armenia by the deputies of the National Assembly of the Republic of Western Armenia. Garnik Sarkisian was born in 1958. He has been raised in the intellectual's family. He received his primary education at the college named after Gulbenkian in Damascus and secondary education in Syria state schools. He graduated Damascus State University as engineer constructor. In his younger years, he was involved in various union and national activities within the frames of the Armenian General Benevolent Union and Armenian Democratic Liberal Party. In 1976, he founded the Union of Armenian Students in Damascus and became the first president of that union. Being a supporter of the national liberation movements, he has done several political, diplomatic, and patriotic activities. He has unique studies and various written and oral political works, especially about the dark folds of our nation's political history. He has a strong faith in the determination and dignity of our nation. With a great consciousness and actual facts, he knows that the national rights of Western Armenia are established and are subject to implementation if we Armenians succeed in elaborating and developing our collective consciousness towards that reality. In order to achieve this definite goal, he joined the state structure of Western Armenia in March 2016 as Minister of Foreign Affairs. Then in June 2017, he became the Prime Minister of Western Armenia. He considers himself as a very uncompromising politician on national and state issues. On the other hand, he believes in liberal and broad-minded approaches in the international relations and during negotiations. He does not have prejudices and believes that there is a need for interstate dialogues with all the sides of the world and states. He highlights the necessity and importance of ensuring mutual interest without considering our nation's interests and rights. It is important for him that our compatriots from all around the world always be informed and involved in all the works concerning our nation. Aghvan Hovhannes Donakanyan was born in 1979 in the Akhalkalaki region. From 1986 to 1997, he studied at the secondary school number 13 after Hovsep Orbeli in Rezdan, Armenia. After receiving secondary education, he studied in Armenian State Pedagogical University, named after Khachatur Abovian, and got a qualification of the inspector pedagogue. Then he moved to the Russian Federation. He is married and has four children. Since 2005, Aghvan Donakanyan has been actively engaged in different social works. He has been working with various youth organizations in Russia to deal with various problems of Armenia, Javakh and Jura. Since 2011, he is a member of the Council of the Union of Armenians from Javakh in Russia and has the youth department. In Moscow, he has actively participated in many events related to Armenia and Armenians. He also took part in different discussions and works carried out on Javakh issues. Living in Moscow, Aghvan Donakanyan is not indifferent to the problems of Armenian people. He is trying to show his support as much as possible and solve various problems. For many times, he has participated in events dedicated to the genocide against Armenians and also in the events dedicated to Armenians of Kassab. He also took part in various issues related to Syrian Armenians. He believes that Armenian people from all over the world must fight together to build powerful Armenia and contribute to the creation of the Western Armenian Republic and the protection of the rights of Armenian nation. The first and the second sessions of the second convocation of the National Assembly of Western Armenia were completed on 20th January. As we have already announced, took place the only legitimate legislative and the final forming of executive bodies of the Republic of Western Armenia. On the last day of the session, deputies and the government officials who were in Yerevan visited Genocide Against Armenians Memorial Complex Tsitsernakabert and Yarabulur Military Cemetery. They paid an homage to millions of innocent victims and brave sons who sacrificed their lives for their homeland. After 22 years, the earthquake map has been updated. According to the new map, the risk of earthquake has dropped in 46 provinces in contrast to the 6 provinces where it has increased. Earthquake Department has updated the earthquake map, which was used since Earthquake Department has updated the earthquake map, which was used since 1996. The new map was officially presented on January 1, which was based on recent earthquake data. According to the new map, the current threat has dropped from 42% to 17%. According to the new map, the threat of earthquake has dropped in Adana, Bursa, Tigranakert, Antep, Kayseri, Muğla, Mersin, Urfa, Van, and in some other settlements of Western Armenia. But it has increased in Tekirdağ, Aksaray, Karaman, Karin, Rize, and in Trabzon. Dırtat was the chief architect of the Bagatuni royal family. He has greatly contributed to the formation of stylistic direction and compositional principles in the medieval Armenian architecture and sculpture. Most of the information about Dırtat we know from historian Stepanos Daroneti. Dırtat possessed Armenian, Arabic, and Greek, and studied Armenian architecture in depth. His construction activities were mainly concentrated in the capital Ani and Agina. The masterpiece of Dırtat's works is the Cathedral of Ani, with its unique composition of the era's architectural perceptions. The doors are decorated with different shades of tuff. The cathedral is considered to be unique in the history of Armenian architecture. Dırtat has also clarified the principal forms of the composition of the cult structure and decoration. On Gagik the First Order, Dırtat also built St. Gregory the Illuminator Church in Ani. Dırtat as an architect was also well known outside of Armenia. In 989, he was invited to Constantinople to rebuild the dome and the damaged walls of St. Sophia Cathedral, which were damaged by the earthquake. According to the Stepanos Daroneti, Dırtat restored the dome, which is still standing. Rezdan Tokmajan, a painter and researcher, has studied Armenian women's embroidery art in Maraş, Urfa, and Antep. He mentions the work of Antep, Urfa, and Maraş show that Armenian culture is a whole. The survivors of the genocide against Armenians from Maraş, Urfa, and Antep have managed to bring Aleppo their heritage of embroidery as a handmade work. Armenians of Aleppo were strongly attached to their traditions and were very interested in crafting. Embroidery of Cilician women is very rich, beautiful, and multifunctional. There are two kinds of embroidery works in Maraş. straight texture and secret texture. We can make straight texture embroidery works in another regions too, but secret texture is typical to Marash. When we have a look at the works of Urfa, we see that floral patterns are dominant. Simple and sophisticated patterns of embroidery reflect the spirit of the medieval painting. Here we can also notice motifs of Eastern and Western culture. One of the main features of Antep's embroidery is the lace work. In Antep's lace work, we often see an octagonal star, which is considered a sign of holiness. We can meet the same motifs in Van. According to Daniel Varujan's article from Navasart, there is an octagon star on the crown embroidered on the Grand the Great's coin. This was all for today. Goodbye.